Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about room frequency response. A lot of inquiries from customers about the room that they have. It has this size. They have these sources, sound sources in the room. They have these low frequency drivers with these diameters. A lot of them don't go through the next step and measure the room response, but you know, obviously we can predict a little bit with dimensions and sound sources and things like that. But some do have measurements, and this is an issue I see all the time that's confusing for them. So let's talk a little bit about it. Let's say you run a room frequency response, and what is that? Well, that's the signature of the room. That's how the room reacts to sound energy that's put within it. That's its signature, just like when you sign your name to a document, to a check, a contract, or anything like that, that's your signature authorizing it. Well, this is the room authorizing the sound that's in it. And this is a picture of how it is authorizing it in that manner. Okay? And usually it's not smooth, because today's rooms are very small, so there's a lot of issues that we have to address. A common graph that I see in rooms that are measured are peaks and troughs. So we have high points and low points. If we take this as our baseline and our center measurement, we have energy signatures above the line, and we have energy signatures below the line. Now, what do those two energy signatures have in common? What does a peak of plus 10 dB and a dip of minus 10 dB have in common? What do both of these areas have in common? Well, the one thing they have in common is pressure. These signatures are both reactions, the room's reactions to certain frequencies. Let's say here and here. The room reaction to 500 and 200 cycles. So it really doesn't like 200. And it really doesn't like 500. Now, what way does it not like those? Since they're both pressure related, one is an exaggeration, one is an attenuation or lack of energy. You can't EQ your way out of these. You can't dump 500 cycle energy into this pressure area and bring it back to normal. Not if it's minus 10, minus 15 dB. You can't do it. You can blow your EQ up trying, but the room simply won't let you. So both of these peaks and troughs are reactions to pressure. You squeeze your lips together and then blow out and your cheeks expand. That's how your room is reacting to pressure. That's how the room is reacting to 200 cycles in our example here. So it's all about pressure. So how do we manage that pressure? Well, that's where different sound absorption technologies come in. So if this is a common situation that we see, what's a good graph to look at? Well, we want something like this. We want something plus 2 or minus 2 over our baseline. Not easy to achieve, but not difficult. Most of your professional recording studios, most of your top engineering design firms use this as a guideline. So it's a good marker. You can see in our top examples, and this is typical of some of the room responses that we receive, big, big difference. This is minimal room sound. This is lots of room sound. Thank you.